Hello friends, my name is Pavlo Biriukovych, Greengo House Company. Today I will show you how to install underfloor heating system without concrete screed. Main advantages of the system: minus 87 kilograms per square meter compared of system with a screed. You save 7 centimeters of floor level and save up to 30% of heat by minimizing heat loss and minimizing heat inertia of the system. That system consists of high-density XPS polystyrene foam thickness of 4 cm. The XPS milled grooves for your system are used typical models. On the example of this exhibition sample, I consider you what the system consists of. There are several types in the standard system core modules. These are swivel, straight sections and manifold approach module. Also included in the system, heat distribution plates, which have a special shape for best heat dissipation. These plates fit easily into grooves. Further into these plates, a pipe with a diameter of 16 mm is laid. The pipe fits simply, securely fixed. We complete the system several standard sized plates. We already cut aluminium of different lengths, 500, 300 and 115 mm long, and you get them bundles. 0.8 mm aluminium thickness makes it easy to trim it if necessarily. The system is very simple. Even a child will cope with installation. How will the system be installed? At 12 o'clock, a car arrived with material. We unloaded and prepared for installation. Our floors are in almost perfect condition. Different of level on the floor is no more 5 mm. It's a one bedroom apartment of 57 square meters. There are the island in the kitchen, therefore the system laying will take more time. Floor mats laid in this place where they will be mounted according to this layout scheme. Always with an individual underfloor heating system, we are making a project. And we are preparing the system for installation, and there is a theme for this. Let's get started. That's how the system is assembled. Now we can start sticking polystyrene foam modules. First, we laid down the system and reduced all the contours of the warm floor. If necessary, polystyrene mats are easily cut with a construction knife. That it remains to stick polystyrene foam to the base. Put aluminum plates and pipe. Look further. Everything is glued. We can start laying heat distribution plates. Heat distribution plates mounted. We can start laying the pipe. all the pipes are laid and start connecting them to the heating system manifold. And this heating system can be started. Therefore, you can continue to lay tile to the magnetic plates or thick ferrocement screed, 5 or 8 mm thick. Type of mesh that we can use for this: 10 or 12 to 12 tail, 0.7 mm thick welded galvanized steel mesh in 3 layers. We will try to show you how to do this. Proceed to connect the manifold. Connection to the collector occurs through that system. Which there is such of comb with a seal. Part goes into the pipe and crimped by such a crimping ring and nut. We connect the pipe to the feet which run along the outer walls. Our pipe went along the outer walls. This is supply line. Well, respectively, the other is a return. Here you can see by the balancer how the contour water is collected. The air valve is activated. Bleed the system. This circuit we will have fill and recruit the following. Soon as he stops, move to the next circuit. The system is filled, you can start the pump. System is filled with water, warm flow launched, you can proceed to lay in fluorine. 57 square meters of warm flow, its time took 10 hours. We work together as you saw it in the video. Before laying the mesh, the system must be primed. After we primed the system, it's dry up, has this appearance, excellent adhesion, and then proceed to installation of the grid. For manufacture of density reinforced cement micro screed, 5-7 mm thick. The mesh of 0.7 or 1 mm thickness with a cell of 10 or 12 mm. The number of grid layers depends on the tile format. The smaller the tile, the more layers to mesh you need. For fastening of first layer of mesh, we are used such plastic dowels that are applied to fastening to expanded polystyrene. It was sold at any building store. The first layer of mesh rolled on the surface and fixed with dowels with a screwdriver. After this, the following mesh layers are stacked with joints overlap, which bind to each other, use wire 0.8 mm thick. After the grid is laid and binded, you can start putting the mesh layer in the elastic tile adhesive. After the glue has set, you can start laying tiles in the traditional way. With this method of laying tiles, every 6 square meters must be left compensation clearance, which filtered with colored silicone in the color of grounding tiles. Also, compensation clearness need to be left around the perimeter of the rooms in order of execute excessive stress on the cracking of the fugue after grounding the tiles. To make it convenient for you to fill out silicone expansion joint, use soapy water as shown in the video. So, from the moment then we start laying at the floor's heating system, to start general heating, 5 days have passed. 72 hours after tile laying, can start the heating system in camo mode. If you like the system, you can order it by email indicated under this video. If this video was useful to you, put like, subscribe our channel, and see you.